love the old legend of Beauty and the Beast. I used to be the law around here. Sheriff Otto, they called me. And I knew the Beast. And I'm telling you that what really happened was far, far more terrifying than anything the storytellers ever admitted. It started in the royal palace, where King Maximilian lay dying.
Bring me my son. Bring me my son.
Your son died at birth, Your Majesty, many years ago. You have to choose a successor.
And choose from among those present, Your Majesty, us, your noble relatives.
A word with you, cousin. You and I are our leading contenders for the throne.
I am the leading contender, Count Rudolph. You were just one ambitious noble among many.
So you wouldn't consider perhaps forming an alliance? Maybe working together?
I know you too well, cousin. You're mean, vicious, and cruel.
And ruthless. You forgot to mention ruthless.
Did I?
Yes. Never forget. Ruthless.
Help. Somebody help me. For the love of God, somebody help! Duke Edward.
He seems to have suffered a ruthless accident.
Very good, Rudolph. You show real promise.
Washing doesn't smell right.
What would you like the dirty washing to smell like, Mother?
Like the old mixture you made, you know? It had lavender and eucalyptus and queensbane, and all the customers said it made their washing smell nice and fresh.
Well, she's right, you know, Belle. That's why I bring my washing here, because of all the wonderful scents you put in it.
Well, I'm sorry. We're all out of that mixture, Dr. Thorne, but I'm making a new one today. You want to smell?
Ah, Belle, always the experimenter.
Well, it was watching you mixing medicines growing up. That made me think it was such a wonderful thing.
Well, it is, Belle. I mean, there's nothing more satisfying than seeing someone who's sick and knowing you have what they need to bring them back to health.
And where did you get those from?
From the forest, like all the others. Essence of oak.
Oil of pine, camphor leaf.
Camphor and pine? I have a feeling they may not go well together.
Anyway, you spend far too much time wandering around the forest. It's a dangerous place.
Come on, Mom. The forest is wonderful and beautiful, and I love it.
And in all your explorations, you've never seen any sign of the famous Beast?
The Beast? Oh, that's just a story that people make up to scare themselves.
Oh, I guess this one could use some work.
I knew there was something about that combination.
If that had happened in my washing boiler.
Mother, it's all trial and error. Besides, I'll go out and get some herbs for a new combination.
You're not going out now.
Why not? There's no time like the present.
Besides, Dr. Thorne doesn't want his washing smelling bad, does he?
By Astaroth and Ishtar, by Beelzebub and Azor Mazda, by all the hearts of darkness that seethe beneath this fated earth, I command you to come forth.
Water the horses.
Yes, sir!
So, Count, concerning the throne, do you think it will come to a fight?
Let me put you this way. I want you to start recruiting more men. If I can't bring the nobles around with persuasion, it may take a show of force.
You'll need more than that, Count.
Lady Helen, to what do we owe the pleasure?
I've come here to help you become king, cousin. Shall we step aside? I was impressed with how decisively you dealt with Duke Edward, Rudolph.
Duke Edward's death was nothing more than an unfortunate accident.
Come on. I have ways of seeing these things, you know that.
That's right, I forgot. You dabble in witchcraft.
Witchcraft? That can help you reach the throne.
And why would you do that? What could possibly be in it for you?
The fact that I would also like to be on the throne. As your queen.
Excuse me.
Am I not beautiful?
Your heart's as black as hell, and everyone knows it.
If you want to be king, Rudolph, you'll need my black heart.
I'll get the throne without your help, my lady. Good day.
Oh, no, you won't. Because I have at my disposal something that will destroy any hope you have.
What exactly would that be?
think about my offer, Rudolph. Think about the pleasure I can give you. And the power. And what I might do if you spurn me.
Lady Helen. Lady Helen! Lady Helen!
Count, are you all right?
Of course I am. Take more than a witch to scare me.
Well, well. My pretty maiden. What's your story?
The beast tried to kill me.
The beast is nothing more than a legend. You've let your imagination run away with you, young lady.
Do I look like an idiot? The beast killed a wolf right in front of my eyes with a crossbow, and then he tried to kill me.
Crossbow? That's the weapon that the beast is supposed to use.
Well, certainly be another feather in my cap if I was the one to capture it.
Show the beast's head to the people. They've got to make you king. The people will adore you for your bravery.
Which way to this beast?
Back there in the woods.
A little vague. No matter. You're taking us. Spread out. Look for traps.
Move along.
Spread out, men. Right away, Captain.
There's no need to hold me so tight, Count. I'm quite comfortable on horseback.
But I like holding you tight, Belle. Besides, how often does a washerwoman's daughter get the chance to be intimate with a lord? You should feel flattered.
Problem is, I don't, so get your lecherous hands off me.
You need a lesson in manners, wench.
And you need a lesson in common courtesy.
Little trollop.
His head!
By all that's holy.
Over there!
There it is! There's a beast! After it!
I'll deal with you later.
Let's go down!
Window, sir.
Get the people out.
Somebody going after the beast.
Move it!
Move! I'm in!
Help him! Sheriff. Otto. What happened? You look as though you've seen a ghost.
They're gonna kill him.
Police? Isn't that a good thing?
He never did anybody any harm.
Otto. I saw him tear a man's head right from his body.
You saw it?
I saw the body.
How do you know the beast was responsible?
Fire into the window!
Fire! What in the name of all that's holy brought it to our village?
There it is!
Let's go!
He's gone into the woods!
I promise each and every one of you, here and now, I will see justice delivered. I, Count Rudolph of Breslau, will destroy that beast.
Otto. Otto, what's the matter?
I have to.
You have to what?
Talk to him.
Who?
I have to.
Someone! Help me! Help me get him home!
Stay together, man.
And so they went off after the beast. At the very minute when I could do nothing to stop them. I'd been afraid of something like this for years. And now it had come. I was helpless. And without me, I knew the beast was doomed.
You must rest.
He needs me. He needs me.
What are you talking about? That thing just killed Dr. Thorne.
No, you don't understand.
Please, Sheriff, get some rest. What's going on? Is anybody here?
The beast!
Otto in the village.
Otto.
Yes. Otto. He's very sick. He couldn't come, but he's worried about you.
He used to bring me food when I was small.
It was you who saved me from the wolf, wasn't it? With the crossbow.
Yes.
And then you turned and fired your crossbow at me. Why would you do that?
To make you go away. I did not want you to see me.
Why did you kill those people? Tear them to pieces?
What people? I have killed no people.
Someone killed them. I saw Dr. Thorne torn apart.
I killed to eat. Only to eat. Ask Otto.
Otto said you didn't kill them. But he's sick. He's very ill. That's why I came.
You've brought hunters to kill me, haven't you?
No! No! I didn't! No!
You stay here! Stay here! Don't
move! No! You've got it all wrong! No! Those men here. I believe and trust you. I wouldn't trust that ambitious rat Rudolph, though. As far as I'm concerned, Count Rudolph can rot in hell. So who are you? What's your name?
Beast.
No, that's just what they call you. What's your real name?
Drink this.
You must have a name.
If I have, I don't know what it is.
Well, someone must know. Perhaps Sheriff Otto? Did he bring you here?
I don't know. All I know is he used to come here when I was small. He taught me to hunt. He was good to me.
Did he give you this?
I don't know. I don't think so. think I've always had that. Since I was a baby.
What is this pattern around the rim?
My pattern.
You're very clever.
I have a lot of time on my hands in the winter. When the wind howls and the snow falls, I sit by the fire and carve. The pattern of the beast.
Don't call yourself that.
But it is what I am.
I'd hope that was for me. But perhaps we could share it. As a kind of loving cup. A pledge of our future partnership.
What the hell are you doing here?
I've come to soothe you. I understand you've had a very trying afternoon.
What the hell could you know about my day?
Everything, cousin. You see, that monster was my creation.
The beast.
Oh, it wasn't the beast that killed the doctor or your men.
Then what was it?
It was my troll. A vicious, maniacal killing machine controlled only by me. With a little help from this.
A troll?
Yes. And unless you pledge your troth to me, dear Rudolph, that troll will ensure you never get anywhere near the throne of our beloved country.
So what are you gonna do now?
Do?
Well, you can't stay here anymore. They'll just send more men to kill you. Do you have somewhere else you can hide?
I have a shelter up between the hills.
Yes. Stay there, hidden, until I come back.
You will never come back.
Of course I will.
Why?
What do you mean, why?
You don't have to pretend you want to see me again.
You have had some horrible things happen to you. I guess I feel like some of it's my fault.
So, Count, what will it be? Are we partners or not?
Say I were to entertain the idea and you call off your troll. How does that help me get the throne?
I'll help you catch the beast. The beast is famous. If you were to bring him down, the whole kingdom would look up to you. And you and I would ascend the throne.
How in the world could I possibly trust you?
That's simple. I need you. They will not allow a woman to rule alone. But with you by my side, anything is possible. And without me, you don't stand a chance. Here's to a great partnership.
Drink to success, milady. I haven't decided on the partnership yet.
My lord.
Count.
Sorry to disturb you, Count. He told us to bring you any news as soon as it came. We found this one coming out of the forest.
Well, well, well. If it isn't my little Spitfire. Washerwoman's daughter, right? I believe you and I have a little unfinished business.
You know this woman, Count?
She's the one who alerted us to the Beast's rampage.
Then had objections when I took her with me to go find it.
What I objected to was you fondling me like some lecherous old goat. Well, is that what you think of him? Let me look at you.
I can see why Count Rudolph got so excited. You're quite a beauty, aren't you? And you saw the Beast? I said, did you see the Beast?
I have nothing to say to you.
How dare you speak to your superiors like that, you trollop? What did you see?
I believe the, rack may loosen her tongue, my lady.
Oh, no. There is no need for that, Count. I have much better methods. Show me more. Is that possible?
What is it?
I thought it was dead.
You thought what was dead? The monster?
What is this?
It's just a hair, my lady.
But it's not one of hers. I'm done with her now.
But I haven't yet. Take her to the dungeon. Secure her. I'll be down later.
Where are you? Come along. She's still under, sir.
Well, she'll come around soon enough. And then, wish she hadn't. Take her away.
That Beast must be killed.
You speak the obvious, m'lady.
No, there is another reason. It could be that the animal known as the Beast stands between us and the throne.
What's the problem?
Count's order, sir. To the dungeon.
Chain her properly.
Look at her, sir. She's away with the fairies.
Stop! Away with the fairies! You're away with the fairies, you moron! Open the door!
Not with the bitches locked.
Get an axeman.
What the hell?
Norman!
Yes, sir!
Rush at him!
Yes, sir!
I'm gonna break your damn neck!
We've nearly got it, sir!
We need to talk about the Beast.
So you keep saying. So why don't you tell me, how does this Beast stand between me and the throne?
Stairs! Stairs!
Do you remember the stories about Maximilian's only son?
It was deformed, wasn't it? It died at birth.
Well, that's what we thought. That's what I believed until tonight.
And now?
And now I believe he may not have died. That the Beast may actually be Maximilian's son.
nothing here, sir.
That over there. All clear over here, sir.
Who else knows this?
Nobody, I hope.
Then what does it matter?
Because if somebody finds out...
Then what?
The shutters aren't fastened.
There's no way down there, sir. It's impossible.
Give me a torch! Hurry!
Listen, having that monster alive is like having a sword hanging over our head.
And no one in their right mind is going to accept that beast as heir to the throne, even
Stop
if it is
arguing
Maximilian,
and sir. Understand this. The beast must die, and he must die as soon as possible.
Agreed. The problem is going to be finding him.
Anything, Captain?
There she is.
We got her! Come on! Quick! Guys!
It might just be that the beautiful Belle has given us what we need to find him. The hair of the beast. By thorn and by root, by blade and by chalices, I call upon that from which this comes. Beast of the forest, can you hear me?
What? Who is that?
A friend. A friend that wants to warn you.
Where are you? Show yourself.
Belle is in grave danger.
Belle?
The troll is on the track. He will be there by morning. Only you can save her.
How?
It's up to you, Beast. Go to her house in the village. Save her.
I can't see you. I don't know who you are.
Why should I believe you?
Don't believe me if you choose. But then, my friend, the troll will tear her apart, and it will be your fault. Well, I think we got him hooked.
Impressive.
Now, all you have to do is make sure you're there.
Through this way.
Yes, sir.
That business about the troll, is that true?
Yeah, it will be.
Because I have seen this creature, and he's dangerous.
Well, now that you and I are partners, Count, you're in no danger. That troll is under my command.
You're absolutely sure of that?
Oh, yes. Remember, he will do anything for a drop of this. And, of course, he wouldn't hurt anyone I didn't want hurt.
And there's no need for you to come with me tomorrow morning.
There is every need. The beast must not be allowed to say a word before he is killed.
You're absolutely sure he'll be in that house tomorrow morning?
Well, if he's not, we have to make sure he is. It must look like he did the killings. And don't worry. My creation has his instructions.
Over there, sir, look!
The dog's going that way, sir.
No, she's heading for the stream.
Sir?
She's gone into the water to throw the dog with the scent.
We just followed the stream into where she came out.
Try to keep up.
Across to you. That way.
washerwoman? Where does the washerwoman live?
Over there.
Thank you.
It's time.
Spread out, surround the house. Let no one pass. First person to bring me the head of the beast wins 1,000 florins.
Oh, wait now! Listen! The troll is coming through the roof! He's coming to get you!
The sheriff will be here any minute!
Open the door, or you're going to die!
Beast has met his match. Murderous rampage is finished. And the people of our beloved country will have me to thank for your death.
Congratulations, Count. People owe you a debt of gratitude.
You say the congratulations when the job's finished.
Of course, sir. As soon as the trial is over, we'll be singing your praises.
Trial?
Put these on him.
Of course, I know.
What trial? We caught the beast red-handed.
He certainly looks guilty, Your Honor, with the poor old laundress lying dead. But King Maximilian's law insists we try people.
King Maximilian?
Before executing them. And I know you're sworn to uphold those laws, just like the rest of us, while the king's alive. So if you'll excuse me, Your Honor.
Oh.
Count Rudolph has subdued the beast. Trial will take place tomorrow. Come to the window, my lord, and accept the acclamation of the people. We'll take it from here. The jail's very strong.
Thank you. Thank you.
Come on, come on. You don't want him escaping, do you? Come on.
Damn it.
You vainglorious fool. Why didn't you kill him when you had the chance?
Get him inside the jail before they turn on him. Get him locked up, and bring me the key.
Get back, all of you. Move him.
What? What's going on here?
I'm sorry, Belle.
What are you sorry about?
Stop something, Terry.
What? What's her whole thing that happened to her?
You can't go in there.
Let me...
You can't go
sorry, Belle. It appears the beast has killed your mother.
No!
It was only my regard for the law that stopped me from
Let
killing
me
her on the spot.
My mother!
Trial must be swift and just.
No!
This beast must not be allowed to commit an atrocity like this again.
Jury was sworn in as soon as possible, my lord, and in the meantime, our grateful thanks.
Till tomorrow, then.
You fool. You should have killed him when you had the chance.
She worked so hard. She worked so hard for me. I could never tell her how much I loved her.
Oh, I think she knew.
I could never tell her.
Who's there?
Try that again, and I'll throw this right between your eyes before you have time to pull the trigger. Just try it!
We'll never forget your mother, either of us.
But it's my fault.
Your fault? How?
I met the beast. I trusted him. If it wasn't for me, he would never have come here.
You don't think the beast killed your mother, do you?
Otto, the beast was found beside my mother's body.
It was a trial, Belle. It was a trial. He told me.
That's what he said, yeah, back at the village. It was a troll. I mean, where is this troll? Anytime he comes around, something bad happens, and he is a monster.
No, 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 no.
What's really going on here, Otto? Who is this beast?
Well, it all started when Maximilian fell in love with Lady Helen of Augsburg. For a long time, she was the only woman for him. He couldn't take his eyes off her. They went everywhere together.
I thought they never married.
Now, people say he discovered she was cruel-hearted and a sorcerer. He shunned her, and, well, they became bitter enemies. The king... married the beautiful Elizabeth of Austria. And eventually, they had a child.
But I thought the king was childless. I thought the queen died giving a stillborn.
No.
No, Helen cast a spell on the baby, and it was born terribly deformed. Poor Maximilian was distraught at the death of his wife, and he couldn't accept the child.
How do you know all this, Otto?
I was a servant in the palace, and I was ordered to dispose of the child. Though he was hideous, I couldn't bring myself to do it. I took him to an old hunting lodge deep in the forest that I went to with my father as a boy. And I'd bring the lad food as often as I could, but eventually he didn't need it. I taught him to hunt for himself.
Does the king know he still has a son?
No, no. No one does. As I got to know him, I realized that beneath that horrible exterior was one of the kindest, gentlest beings I have ever known. A true prince, Belle. I promise you that.
A true prince? Does he know?
It would have been too cruel.
It sounds like you really care for him.
As if he were my own son. And I know he could never do any of the things he's been accused of.
I believe you. It's just...
What?
I think I care for him, too.
Come on, let's go see him.
Who goes there?
It's me, Sheriff Otto. Let us through.
Halt!
What's she doing here?
She has the right to confront the killer of her own mother, doesn't she? Now let us past.
Well, I warn you, it's got a weapon. Could kill you without even leaving his cell.
How did that happen?
Never mind.
Yeah, well, we'll take our chances. There's no need for the rest of you to stay here the whole night. The jail's secure enough, whether he's got a weapon or not.
Count's orders. We stay here until the thing's executed. Waste of time putting it on trial, if you ask me.
I did not kill her.
I know. I believe you. Otto told me your real story.
What real story?
About who you are. I think you should know the truth.
Well, no. All right, then. You're probably right.
Damn her eyes. Why didn't that fool Rudolph get rid of him when he could? And why didn't I get rid of her? I'd send you in, my little one. But we can't risk letting anyone see you now, can we? Not until the beast has been proven guilty. But after that, there'll be plenty of work to do, won't there?
So you shouldn't be in this jail cell. You should be in the royal palace, acclaimed as the next king. It's true. Don't you believe it?
I believe you. I believe Otto. But who else will believe?
If Helen used sorcery, if she cast a spell, perhaps it could be broken.
Broken?
Well, in the stores, it's usually something.
What?
Come here. Closer. Put your face between the bars.
What are you doing?
Close your eyes.
You kissed me.
I was trying to break the spell.
Not so easy, I think.
No.
All right, that'll do. Time for you to go. You need your beauty sleep.
The king is dead! The king is dead!
do you think you're doing?
Following orders.
This is a trial, not a torture chamber.
Prisoner has to be kept secure for the safety of the jury and also kept
quiet. I am the sheriff here, and I will not let you do that.
It's on account of you we're doing it.
What?
The beast attacked you.
What are you talking about? Of course it didn't attack me.
Oh, yes, he did. Vicious, huh? Dump him somewhere.
By the time he wakes up, it'll be all over.
You find her?
No, sir.
What?
House is empty. We've been around the whole village. Looks like she's escaped, sir.
You're an idiot.
Never mind. We've got the place surrounded. If she tries to get in, we'll have her then. And after he's dead, it won't matter, will it?
And he woke me up and said, "Where's the washerwoman's house?" And I showed him. And then he slammed my head against the table.
The washerwoman was torn to pieces, and the beast was standing over her, covered in blood. It's the same monster I saw coming out of the old hunting lodge. And there he tore men apart in minutes.
Well, I believe that's enough from the prosecution. Is there anyone here to stand up for the accused? Anyone? Sheriff Otto. Is Sheriff Otto here to stand up for the accused?
Sheriff Otto is too ill to attend, my lord. It seems the beast attacked him as well.
And the beast himself has nothing to say. Members of the jury, have you reached a verdict? Is the beast guilty or not guilty of the death of the washerwoman Anna?
He's guilty.
We have, my lord.
What say you? Guilty or not guilty?
Guilty, my lord.
Quiet! Quiet!
I hereby announce sentencing. Death by beheading. Immediately. The axe fall.
Quick! Mine!
Who threw that? I can't see your face!
I think it's time to go, don't you? Oh, bastards.
Thank you.
Keep your hands apart. Keep them on the block.
They're getting away!
Justice having failed, Troll, it's time to set you loose again. This time, it's the beast. I know, he's stronger than you and almost as ugly. But would you like some of this? Hmm? Well, you'll get some once you've got him for me. And I'm going to give you a little help. Do you know what this is, Troll? This turns living beings into stone.
Oh.
And here is the perfect way of providing the beast with the required dose. Now that the mixture is on the dagger, all you have to do is stick it in. You're not too afraid of him to do that, are you?
Good.
Now go into the forest and hunt him down. Oh, and Troll, if the girl is with him, then you're in the mood. Feel free to rip her head off.
You came back for me.
Of course I did.
Why?
I guess I thought it was the right thing to do.
They could have killed you.
It was still the right thing to do. And also...
Yes?
Because I care about you.
We need to search for Otto.
I know, but that's not the first thing.
What?
We have to get to the heart of this. Where it all began, who it began with.
The sorceress.
Exactly. What?
I'm ashamed to say it, but I feel fear at her name.
You should be angry. Furious. She destroyed your life.
Anger, yes. I feel anger. But she made me as I am. I fear what her magic could do to me.
So you have to destroy her.
Can she be destroyed?
I don't know. But if she isn't, then she and Count Rudolph will have this country in the palm of their hand.
What does that matter to me? You think the people would take me as their king?
No. Probably not.
Then why should I do it?
Because it's the right thing to do. And because I hope that you care for this land and the people in it.
The people who shunned me. The people who spat at me. The people who wanted to kill me.
Yes, those people. The frightened people, the ignorant people, and also the good people. People like Otto, people like my mother. They need someone to stand up for them.
Against the sorceress.
Against the sorceress.
You ask a lot, Bill.
And you have a lot to... Are you all right?
Yes. Yes, he didn't touch me. But I've decided something.
Yes.
The witch must die.
You look like a real hunter.
A witch hunter.
A monster hunter. I'm sorry, I wasn't thinking. But a troll is a monster, and you aren't.
I just look like one.
Not to me. And besides, what makes a monster is their souls, not their hides. So you and I are real monster hunters.
You're not thinking of coming with me.
If we go hunting, my friend, we go together.
Stupid fool!
I gave you the most powerful magic I possess. I gave you the best dagger ever made, and you fail? I ought to put you in the cauldron from which you came. Get in the cage! No! You haven't earned it, so you don't get it! No! No more until I say so! And should something happen to me, no one in the world knows how to make more. Get in the cage! You'll be back sooner or later. You'll do anything for a drop of that. Now, for that damn beast. Smoke? To the killing zone, beast. I call on Azur Mazda, god of the storm. Kill me, I suppose.
No one deserves to die more than you do.
I'm sure you're right, but consider one thing before you shoot.
What's that?
I made you what you are.
Which is just one reason why you should die.
And the whole reason why I should live. Because only I know how to turn you back. If you kill me, you will stay a beast forever. Spare me, and I'll turn you back into the prince you really are. Now, isn't that a wonderful bargain?
You're evil!
Quite true. But you see this? These came from your head when you were still human. I used them against you. And I also used them to give life to my troll, your life. And only I can take it from him and give it back to you.
Only you?
You need me, beast. This country needs me. With my power and your strength, we could rule it together.
Show me you can do it. Change me back into what I am.
All in good time, dear boy.
No!
You can't threaten me. Not if you want my help, Max.
Max?
Well, that's what your father would have called you. After himself, Maximilian the 14th, before he felt obliged to abandon you.
Take me back now, or you die!
I'm sorry I don't respond well to threats. In fact, I hate them. Nobody tells Helen of Arnsberg what to do. What a perfect morning this has become. I get to kill the beast and slit the throat of his beloved all in one morning.
Ah!
How dare you!
You killed her for me.
There was no choice.
You could have let me die. You could have forced her to change her back.
If you were dead, I would have no reason to go on.
Do you really mean that? Here that can help you. Taking over.
What?
Count Rudolph.
Another.
He's got the troll. He's gonna make himself the new king.
What has that to do with me?
Everything. You're the rightful heir.
I would have been if I hadn't killed the witch.
You still are, no matter what you look like. If Count Rudolph takes over with that monster by his side, this place could turn to hell.
Belle, everybody hates me. And there's only two of us.
Three of us. Don't forget me.
Otto!
You came!
Well, doesn't look like you needed me.
There must be something useful we could take from here.
To me.
And why should we listen to you, Rudolph?
Because we have to select a new king. We have to listen to each other.
To you, you mean?
It's an excellent start. After all, it was I that caught the famous beast of the forest.
Oh, and let it escape again.
That's not fair. Witchcraft was involved.
Ah, witchcraft. And aren't you surprisingly friendly with that famous witch, Helen of Augsburg?
We're not having a witch friend for a king. So pipe down, Rudolph, and get down from there.
Yes, it's true. I'm friends with Lady Helen of Augsburg. In fact, she gave me a gift. A wonderful gift.
Well, take it home and play with it, Rudy.
Uncover it. No. It'd be much more generous of me to let her play with you. You see, there was a time this creature only answered to Lady Helen of Augsburg. But now, it's transferred its affections to me.
Shut it. Shut that door at once.
Pick one of them. Kill them. Just one. Then have some more of this.
We won't be intimidated by some goblin. We're all armed.
My little red friend isn't afraid of your swords.
Attack him!
How about a small round of applause? Nothing? Duke Henry, you wouldn't want to hurt my creature's feelings, would you? Cage.
Gentlemen, nobles, it's time for us to choose a new king.
Excellent work.
I'm aware there are a few of us, equally qualified by rank and by blood, for the title of king. But in view of my recent contributions to the country's safety, I'd like to put my name forward first. I'm going to ask each and every one of you, one by one, if you'll support my becoming the next king. Starting with you, Duke Henry. Do I have your support?
Yes, Cousin Rudolph.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Yes, Cousin Rudolph.
The rest of you, do I have your support?
Yes, my lord.
Well, yes, Count.
Yes, Count.
Of course.
Yes, I will.
Well, I'm honored and surprised by this very unexpected nomination. I accept.
Begging your pardon, Count. Sheriff Otto's captured the beast and the girl.
Bring it here. Bring it here so he may kneel before a new king, so he may administer his justice.
Well done, Your Majesty. Well done for bringing such a monster to justice.
Well, somebody had to do it.
And it had to be you, didn't it? Because you were determined to condemn me for the crimes committed by that monster there.
I don't know what you're talking about. Somebody take him away.
Not until we're finished, Count!
Somebody see him!
Grab him! It appears as if the Count has been using the witch's spawn to intimidate you. But the truth is, there's no need for any king choosing at all. You see before you the rightful heir to the throne.
How can that be possible?
Are you mad, Beast?
No. I am Maximilian XIV, son of Maximilian XIII, transformed at birth into a monster by the sorceress Helen of Augsburg, left to die in the forest, and rescued by this man, who many of you will recognize as once having worked as a groom in this palace.
It's the truth, Your Honors. This is the child the good queen died giving birth to.
And this is the royal cup that was sent away with me.
Who in the world do you think is going to believe such a foolish story?
Anyone with an eye for the truth, Rudolph. Anyone who knows you is the cruel, grasping usurper that you are. Someone like me, for example.
You forget the troll, my friend.
The troll is afraid of me, Rudolph. Almost as much as you are. You see, it was my humanity the sorceress used to give life to that thing. He knows I'm determined to get it back.
You'll leave her. You won't harm her. But only if you renounce any claim you have to the throne. Isn't that right, Troll? All you have to do, say this story's a lie, leave this land, and never return. Say it, and the troll lets her go.
No! Please! That's not true! No! Forget about me! Please! Please! Forget about me!
Say it.
I'll do as you ask. I hereby renounce all claim.
The hell you do!
Get up!
I proclaim the start of the reign of your new monarch. Yes.
Maximilian the 14th. And promise to rule in the name of and for the good of every man, woman, and child in this land.
He did exactly what he promised. As long as that couple ruled, there was peace, there was prosperity, and there was also two very unusual statues, just to remind people how lucky they were.